Always a favourite on every rural road. Hyundai Country Calendar.
The point with pasture free range is that they are actually truly free range with access to grass and food and water and sunshine.
We don't get paid for the extra quality. Instead of just feeding their family, we're feeding the world now, so that's the main thing.
Fantastic really to know that people are seeking the quality food and prepared to seek it out and support us.
A November morning in South Otago, and on the Pringles family farm, they're out collecting eggs. Michelle Pringle is a dairy farmer turned egg farmer. She and her worker, Melanie Woodward, are one of two teams on the job.
So these are about 24 weeks old. They're hitting full production. And it's summer, so the egg production's going up nicely with the daylight hours. So they're laying at about 95% production at the moment. And hopefully they'll hold that for quite a few months. The point with pasture free range is that they are actually truly free range with access to grass and food and water and sunshine. Their farming is about nutrient dense food production, and so that's about working with nature and getting the quality of the egg up there, which means if they've got free choice to eat what they want and then a natural environment, I think the quality is going to be better, which means the food is better for the people to eat, which is the whole point. This afternoon I'm heading off to Mamona Airport to pick up day-old chicks that are flying in from Christchurch.
Michelle got serious 5 or 6 years ago about raising chickens, and it's given the farm new life.
It's always exciting to go and pick up the babies, the day-olds. The majority are brown shavers.
It's an hour's drive from the farm to Dunedin Airport. The chicks have had quite a journey to get here. They've come from a hatchery in Geraldine in South Canterbury. But the fragile cargo looks unscathed.
They look great, yeah. They're looking good. Which one's got the cobs in?
Michelle's husband, Tony, and their children are on hand to unload the birds. The most important thing is to keep them warm.
When we get them home, we try to get them under the lights and with their food and water straight away. We count them in so that we know exactly what's in the shed, so we know what we're feeding and what we're rearing.
12.
We've got Bly and Lily here today helping us unload them because we just got to get them warm straight away, really. They're very fragile, they're tiny wee baby chickens, so you have to be very careful when you're handling them. Be very gentle, yeah. They're drinking water already. Straight away they act like a hen, it's amazing.
The chickens are raised in batches of 1,000. Tony and farmhand Shane Powell have the job of looking after them.
Tony and Shane rear them so quietly and kindly that they're very quiet when they come out into the hen houses at the other end.
They take good care of the birds at every stage of their growth.
These are 7 weeks, these wee fellas. They're about to get let outside next week. As they get bigger, they need more room. These are our oldest ones at 12 weeks, and they've been outside for the last 2 weeks. We feed them twice a day. Sometimes we feed the wee jiggers that turn up, three times, just depends. But generally speaking, it's twice a day we're here, Shane or I. And we always shoot down and make sure everything's ticking over pretty good. So, yeah, we have a good run. We send them out to the hen houses at 16 weeks. When a hen house becomes free, we cart them out there and they start their laying business. We get the odd egg, we start laying early in here, but generally speaking, we get it right.
These are pasture free range hens, which means that they don't have fences and they're on pasture, and we move them around the paddocks or the grass just to keep it fresh.
For Michelle Pringle, it's about keeping everything fresh and healthy, from the eggs to the ground the chickens feed on. It's an approach she owes to her other job, working as a nurse.
You notice things about people's health, and I've had an interest in health, and so it's transferred to an interest in animal health. And you can't just stop there, because it's not the answer, is it? It's not the end of the story. So then you get an interest in the plant health and then the soil health, the microbes, the microorganisms in the soil.
Which is why the Pringles farm biologically. They use only natural fertilisers.
As we've evolved with our biological farming or regenerative farming, one of our focuses has been about interrelated systems, permanent agriculture and systems that support each other. So the hens, obviously, they poo out in the range, which fertilises the ground, and the cows, which of course are an amazing animal with their guts, they produce all the poo and make the ground really healthy for the birds to break down their poo, and on it goes. So this flock are 18 weeks old. These are our point of lay hens. They've just started laying. There won't be a lot of eggs here yet. We've stopped briefly to do a health check, check the water, check the food, just check that everything's all right. These have only just been let outside, so we put a fence around to just train them, really, train them to their house. And in a couple more weeks, we'll take that down once they're full lay, and they'll be free like the rest of them with no fences at all.
They built this big new packing shed in 2016.
We initially had a small hand machine that we worked in. So as the business expanded, we had to expand because we were spending all day, every day, packaging eggs, really. So this has made things much more efficient and made life a lot easier. Got some really great staff. They've been here for a while now, most of them. We're very, very fortunate with our staff. They save my bacon plenty of times. They're looking for flaws, they're looking for cracks, and anything wrong with the egg that's not up to standard. We got into the hens through having home hens and people saying that our eggs were really great. And we didn't really understand what that meant because we didn't eat anybody else's eggs, we only ate our own. We started with one hen house, and then the demand for eggs just carried on, really.
And they say keeping it natural is the key, so they're working with the best that nature has to offer. Kaka Point on the South Otago coast is an hour's drive from the Pringles farm. But Tony Pringle sees it as one of the keys to keeping his land fertile.
We've come down to get a wee bit of seawater to use as part of our liquid fertiliser program on our farm.
Tony's come with a local contractor, Devon Beard, to transport the seawater. And he's also got one of his family to help out with the hard bit.
We brought Jack, my third child. He's had the day off work to come and give us a hand. Get out in amongst the sea and hold the hose. Need someone so we're not sucking up sand. He's happy as Larry to get amongst water. He loves it. We go to about 10 degrees out there, I imagine. So we've been using seawater for 2 or 3 years. And the idea is that seawater's got a lot of heap of biology, microbiology, minerals. It's got energy. So what it does, it brings to life the soil and helps the bacteria, fungi in the soil and everything like that. So it's just a small part, but it plays a real important part. Since we've been using it, we've found that like so the moss has gone on the shady sides of the paddocks, and yeah, it's just paddocks that never used to grow now grow grass. So yeah, it's all good.
Meanwhile, back on the farm, Michelle Pringle is in charge of another vital element in keeping their soil healthy.
This is our worm farm, so this is one of my most favourite things ever. We put all our waste, dairy effluent, and our hen rearing sawdust and all my egg waste, like cartons and stuff, in here. This is nature in action. I think it's just perfect. We've seeded this with worms and they've just reproduced and they're just filling it up with worms and eating it. So there was 60 tonne of food here and they're just reducing it by the day, and they're going to turn this into vermicast, into soil basically. It's an experiment. I keep trying different things, and so I've dumped all these in here, which is, you know, the junk mail that comes. They're starting to work it over. So you can see where they've digested the cardboard from all the packaging, and I put eggs in there as well, and they break down the eggs. They're just amazing, really. So this is going back on the farm. Tony puts it through our fertiliser. Once they've turned it into vermicast, into soil, he'll extract all the microbes out of it in a big giant tea bag, and then we spray it on the farm.
Okay. We started with the seawater, and now we're using some of Michelle's vermicast out of a worm farm. We're just adding a bit of liquid seaweed. We put a wee bit of fish in and a few other ingredients, just depending on the season and the time of year. It just mixes up for half an hour or so, and then it's ready to go onto the paddocks. We've got Jack, he's going to go and spray a couple paddocks where the cows have been. We probably try to get right around the farm three times a year. It's just a seasonal thing, so the idea is a little bit of everything often instead of a big heap. We try to keep the grass length higher. The nutrients are in that top section of the grass, and then when the cows graze it, they're not chewing it right down. We're always trying new things, and it seems to be working this season. It's taken a long time, but the earthworms, the whole soil and everything working, producing higher quality grass where cows eat, produce higher quality milk. We're on a 16-hour milking, so two milkings today, morning, early morning and late this afternoon, and then one around lunchtime tomorrow. So we just got a big long walk and steep hills for the old girls to drive up and down, so that's why we decided to go 16 hours. No grain feeding at all grass fed. If there's a pinch, we feed silage, so still keep it grass fed. We want to produce good quality milk. Nutrient-dense milk, just as with the eggs, nutrient-dense eggs. It all probably come around 23 years ago when our oldest son was born, and we wanted to make sure they all are healthy, eating the best food possible. Best meat off the farm, the best eggs, and the best milk. We don't get paid for the extra quality, but we're trying to, instead of just feeding their family, we're feeding the world now, so that's the main thing, yeah.
After a few decades in the milking shed, Tony's enjoying the variety of doing something different.
When the eggs come along, I've jumped on board big time on that, and it's just another challenge. So I've sort of done everything in dairy. I still enjoy the cows, but the day-to-day milking of them, done it for 30-odd years, so it's time to move on, you know. Still enjoy the stockwork side of things.
The Pringles have also developed another income stream from their chickens. Not only do they sell eggs, they're now selling off their excess birds as well.
We know that we want 700 for a hen house, and so whatever surplus, we need to sell them off because we don't need them, and it generates a little bit of extra income for us as well. So it's become another income stream, and sometimes we rear a flock that we don't need at all just so that our broodery is full and constantly turning over birds. Huge demand. I'm selling off now in advance to February. I've started selling my February flock, so people are on waiting lists for the surplus birds that we don't use. Today we're delivering 40 hens to a fella in Kaka Point.
Yeah.
They're 18 weeks old, so they're ready to go.
18 weeks old?
Yep.
Yeah, they're looking good, Michelle.
But the main business of the week happens on Saturdays, when they take their eggs to market.
The whole idea is to keep everything fresh for everybody.
Dunedin Farmers Market is in the shadow of the magnificent Victorian Railway Station.
Everybody that goes to the farmers market, the customers are foodies, so it's a great place for me to go. Everyone's concerned about where their food comes from, fresh, local produce, that's what it's all about.
Michelle Pringle has two of her children helping out, and the youngest is the face of the business.
Hello.
Lily's the poster girl. We got her on there when she was nine, before she knew what she was letting herself in for, so before she was a teenager. Yeah, it's a bit of a family affair, and Lai's been responsible for the trademark, so yeah, everyone's had a wee hand in it. We've been here a wee while now, and they understand the point of difference for eggs, I think, that we don't have any fences and that they are truly free range, ranging in grass, going about their natural business. Hello, how are you? It's great to build up that relationship with people and get to know them a bit. It's been a busy morning. It's a nice day in Dunedin, no rain. People are all out. So it's been a good day, yeah.
Our business has gone from strength to strength, probably through the farmers market, through the contacts. People go there, like new restaurants turning up, setting up. They'll come to the farmers market and source the food. It's great. It's a very satisfying part of the business.
Michelle has one last delivery to make to Dunedin Cafe Market Garden.
Oh, hey Michelle.
Hi, Alison.
I'm good, thank you. Cheers. Here you go. How's it going?
Yeah, good, eh? You good?
It's good, yeah, great.
Oh, you've got to know Michelle, and I've just had a really good relationship with Michelle because she does what she says she's going to do. Her eggs are the real deal. Everything she gives me is the real deal, and that means a lot, actually. There's no way, as a chef, I can serve a product that I'm not happy with.
Chef Alison Lambert is the cafe owner.
Scrambled eggs, just like my mum cooked, just like I cooked. So, and that's why we sell hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of portions of eggs, but it's all about the eggs. It's just really rich. I never get like a bad egg. Every egg is consistently beautiful. It just reminds me of growing up. We had our own chickens. See that? And there's nothing added to that. That's just absolutely the best eggs I can get.
Michelle's returning home with a delivery of her own, a trial batch of bacon and egg pies. They've been made by a Dunedin baker using their eggs.
How exciting, let's have a look. And that's the final trial for the whole egg small pies. Wow, yum, they look great. So this is hopefully the final. We'll get the taste test done from our friends and neighbours and family.
Tastes good.
Tony Pringle's got in early on the taste test.
Real meaty. And eggy.
Two eggs in it, and the ratio of bacon's good. And I think this is the one, because the eggs are well and truly featured there.
Well, they'll be getting sold online. We're just finishing with a label and just getting organised at the moment, yeah.
They're also planning to market their own chicken stock.
We're processing at end-of-lay hens. Currently, they're a waste product and it's not something that I'm comfortable with. It's wasting a lot of really good protein and nutrients. So we're processing them into stock and broth, and we're going to be selling that at the farmers market and to some local chefs. It's awesome to have a look around and see where we're at.
Come
on! So very satisfying, but so much more to do, which is fantastic because you're a food producer, so you take that responsibility very seriously. So you better be producing really good quality, nutrient-dense food. You just get excited. Well, I get excited, and Tony does all the work.
Sometimes it might look like that. But no, we all work pretty hard, so.
But yeah, there's so many more things we want to do. It's just endless, yeah. I think. Just absolutely endless.
And we're
endless.
Only just starting, like, you know,
yeah.
Another 10 years, hopefully we'll have all the boxes ticked.
Calendar was brought to you by Hyundai New Zealand.